you watch this video, that it brings back as many memories to you as it has to me. This has been an exciting year from the point where it was nothing but a sand pile until looking back now where it's a complete year, and we've had some fantastic accomplishments. I know that the students have worked hard to produce the video, and the students who are in the video have worked very hard too, and I think you're going to enjoy it now and in all the future years to come.
Busy. flipping burgers and serving restaurants and drinks, and it was all the idea of Peter, our fearless leader. We owe it to Peter, he was so proud of us all. Spaghetti, Deutsch, der Melamouche, habla espanol, amo, amas, amadas, English now.
Thank you. And you know what? We've done that today, ladies and gentlemen, just for you. So, this group...
Thank you. Had foremost on their minds the students, and they never turned down an opportunity to interact. River Ridge really was a school of opportunity. Well, now
before. Thank you. Roger, bow line clear. If I could have attention to passengers up in front of the vessel as I pull out of the slip here, I'll be doing a horn signal. Quite loud, you might want to cover your ears.
Thank you. you know. And I'm still I've never found what I couldn't resist, what I couldn't turn down. You know it should be.
Good evening. Y'all look so fantastic tonight, I want to congratulate you. We're going to announce the king and queen, and I've asked Catherine and Ryan to come and crown them. Catherine and Ryan were king and queen of Newcoming. And I could build up a lot of suspense, but I think I'll just announce that the... What suspense? Let's have three more songs.
Yeah!
The king and queen are Mike Conwell and Michelle Blacka.
Thank you. you feeling?
I feel it's very encouraging to do stuff for college and get more, like, it's a good thing.
Hi, my name's Mr. Hicks and
Mr. Swenson.
Okay.
Mr. Hicks? Yes.
The show's just canceled.
Look at my pretty picture.
This is a regular English class, and my students are reading Lord of the Flies, and you will see that they need masks for the book. Does anyone have
a day?
Oh!
Susan Dacey, and I'm Vice President of Student Council. This coming week will be Pride Week. Student Council has planned a lot of fun activities to promote school spirit and pride. We encourage everyone to participate, and we hope that you have a fun week.
I'm Brian Dobbins, President of Student Council. Tuesday will be Positive Day. Everyone is encouraged to say positive things to other students and teachers. On Positive Day, you will turn your frown upside down. Every student will receive a yellow happy.
Wednesday will be Community Service Day. All students should bring in cans to their first parade for Salvation Army.
I'm Tanisha Cummings. I'm the freshman class president. Thursday will be Spirit and Class Spirit Day. Students are encouraged to show school spirit and wear class colors. The day will conclude with the class Pride Puff competition at 7 p.m. at River Ridge Practice Field.
All students are encouraged to show pride in River Ridge by keeping our school clean. We have been given a beautiful new campus, and we must take a stand to keep it clean.
Working with River Ridge High School concerning caps and gowns for next year and announcements, but right now concerning the class rings. And we're going to be talking about class rings, and I promise you, as I promised the students when we had our meeting, when they first looked at the rings some months ago, that the ceremony would run quickly and promptly, and I know that you all have schedules.
This has been an exciting year for me, and I hope it has been for you too. I'm really honored to be able to start a school. It's an opportunity that not many people in their careers get, and to be able to start one as fantastic as this school is something that I'm very proud of. Part of establishing a school is being part of setting traditions that are going to be around long after I'm gone. And one of the enduring symbols of a school is the ring that you're going to receive tonight. It's a ring that will only be worn by our students and graduates of River Ridge. Over a year ago, we brought together a group of students, we brought an artist, we brought representatives of the ring company, and those students started it when they selected the mascot, of the Royal Knight and started the drawings and that later developed in some of the other symbols that we have in the school, one of which is the ring. The ring that you're receiving tonight is a result of that first meeting. I hope in the future that when you look at your ring, it brings back memories of the things that happened while you were here and the traditions that you helped start.
Class ring has a glorious heritage, from the iron bands of Roman slaves to the poison rings of the Middle Ages and the love knot rings of the poets. The finger ring has seen many changes. History does not tell us the exact period or origin, but we do know that rings have been found in tombs of ancient Egypt. The finger ring has always been a mark of distinction, prestige, and influence, worn with pride in every nation of the world. The class ring, as we know it today, originated in the year 1835 and was purchased by the graduates of the United States Military Academy at West Point.
Thank you. the culture fair. Got to get them ready now. Okay, well, they're getting you ready, gentlemen. I want you to listen to a few simple instructions. I know you've been watching the girls dance, but just to give you a little help, I want you to pretend there's a pineapple on a string right in front of you. Now, I want you to give that pineapple a little bump so it'll swing. Can you do that? Okay, there's a pineapple in front of you. Give it a bump. Good. Okay, now there's another pineapple to your right. Give it a bump. And in the back, there's a watermelon. And on the other side, we have an orange. Now I'm going to turn on the music, and I want you guys to make us a fruit salad.
They really were the last to open up to the world.
Come in, Hula. Come on. Come on, we're doing so much.
Right. Just lean it up.
Thank you.
Yeah, and it's about time. Yo, let's rip this up.
Boys the men, boys the men, boys the men.
KORR. Today I'm interviewing Mrs. Meyer, who's the advisor of FBLA. Mrs. Meyer, what does FBLA stand for?
FBLA stands for Future Business Leaders of America. Any students who are enrolled in business education classes are entitled to join FBLA.
What? Listen, tell me, you know, your name and phone number that you are interested, what school you represent. Once we start having meetings, we'll invite you to attend the meetings to get involved.
We hope you join in the fun tonight's game at River Ridge. And it's also a parents' lunch for all of you.
Are you ready?
Yeah! Forward to future productions from our dramatics group.
Don't you get the picture?
Do you want to know what I wanted to buy?
I wanted to speak to you all before you start school at River Ridge. know, we are not yet finished building the school. So we're going to need everyone's help. The students, the teachers, and all of your parents. Now, I know that a lot of you are confused and anxious about switching schools. And because I am too, it must be natural. The key to accepting change is to focus on the goal, not the obstacle. Some people call this having vision. I have great vision. Now, if there was only some way to project you all into the future so that you would know what I'm talking about, I can't think of any way. Wait a minute, yes I can. I know, my personal time machine.
Oh, wow. No.
Everybody